Come on over here. Just realize.
Our death god has been destroyed.
Get out of here, bitch. Kill him softly here, and today we're going to be playing Deadlock. This is the new MOBA slash shooter from Valve that's in alpha testing right now, I guess. We're going to be trying out this character, Yamato. I've only had a chance to play a few of the characters because I haven't played that much of the game. I've just been trying to learn what the fuck a MOBA is. I think I'm getting the hang of it. I've been really enjoying Yamato, though, because basically you just do anime on all the enemies. Who doesn't like that? Mouse 1 is this shotgun knife throw. Your secondary fire are these little spiky balls.
What?
That do like an AoE damage. And they're pretty nice, especially early round. Your first ability is the power slash. It's basically just a charge slash that travels a certain distance and does maximum damage once you have it all the way charged. The next ability is her flying strike. This is probably my favorite thing of her character. Basically, you attach to an enemy and go flying across the map. Her third ability is the Crimson Slash, and this is basically just a wide arching slash that's in front of her. It does damage, not that much, but the biggest thing is that if you hit another enemy hero, it heals you. And her last ability is the Shadow Transformation. This makes Yamato invincible for a short duration. You can use this in team fights pretty well to bait out ultimates from heroes and completely just dodge all the damage from it. Alright, so before we jump into the gameplay, I want to briefly explain what the hell a MOBA is. This is going to be coming from a 20-year first-person shooter perspective, so please feel free to comment anything that I leave out or say incorrectly. This is just going to be my basic understanding of how a MOBA works. You're going to start off in a lane. This is your lane. One side, you have this little tower guardian. The other side has this enemy tower guardian way over there. You've got these little minions on your side, and they also have little minions on their side. Your goal is to push up your lane, take out the minions, earn money, and push up the lane all the way to the very end where you have the enemy team's boss. The goal of the game is to kill the enemy's boss. Collectively as a team, you want to push up your lane and take out the boss. That's the simple gist of it. There's a lot of nuance with this game, so I, like you, find it pretty confusing to watch games like this, understand what the hell the characters are even doing. We'll have a little pause breaks in between the gameplay to kind of explain what the fuck is going on. All right. Yamato. Let's get it. My hair is crazy.
It's crazy!
Alright, first things first. When you get in the lane, obviously you are trying to win your lane. How do you win the lane? By getting souls. So you get souls from either killing the player or from killing the little AI minions. If you finish off a minion by shooting it, it's gonna pop up a little soul orb. That is half of the souls for that minion kill. So you wanna always be shooting the little soul orbs to ensure that you're getting the maximum amount of souls. Also, the reason that I'm punching the minions to kill them is because when you punch kill a minion, you instantly get all of the souls for it without having to worry about shooting it or worrying about the enemy team stealing it from you. As you gather souls, you'll start hitting certain thresholds that give you ability points and the ability to unlock other abilities. Those milestones are different for each character. Basically, all you need to know is as soon as you are able to unlock another ability or as soon as you're able to afford upgrade an ability, you should be doing that. So So right here, I've farmed up enough souls to be able to buy my first item from the shop. All of these items are basically just upgrades for your character, and there are public builds that you can choose from that basically explain to you how to hit out your character for a specific playstyle. I don't know that much about it, so I'm just selecting the number one build for the character, which is centered around using Yamato's sword, her first ability. But I've gotten enough money to buy my first upgrade, and as soon as you do, you want to be buying it. The quicker you upgrade your character, the more powerful you're going to be in your lane. Now right there, the enemy got a little too aggressive with me and let me whittle his health down to the point where I could kill him before he could fall back to his minions or his base. Again, the early objective that you want is to push your lane, but also you don't want to die. So right there, he kind of made a misplay and I was able to capitalize on it. Damn, I missed her. I played that a little too aggressively and pushed up the lane without having my minions there. He was able to spawn back in, quickly push up to me, and he's full health, and I'm already half health. So it was a little mistake I made. Alright, so I'm not doing bad in my lane, but I do want to get my money up a little bit quicker, and he's being pretty aggressive. So what I've decided to do here is go to the jungle camps, and that's where you can farm souls kind of safely without having to worry about them being contested by another player, to ensure that I'm getting money and not falling behind the enemies.
Has arrived.
So while I'm farming souls, he's able to defeat my tower, and I get there just in time for little soul orbs to pop up from his kill, and I want to try to steal as many of those as possible so that he doesn't get them and I do. So we're pretty neck and neck. That's why going to do that little jungle camp and just letting him have the tower was kind of worth it for me. So I look on the map and I see that my minions are kind of holding their own in my lane. Hibiscus has kind of abandoned the lane to go help out elsewhere on the map with his team. So I'm going to farm up a little bit because I'm trying to save up for a $3,000 upgrade item that will really help me kind of snowball from this point forward. So I'm just going to hang around my blue lane and help out a little bit as I can, helping them push up and take their tower, and then I'll probably get them to come help me in my lane after that.
Black holes up!
Let's go.
Thank you.
Can you also help me on my lane?
Excellent work.
Which lane?
Purple. This Viscus over here.
They've taken an objective.
I see Viscus.
Seven's here.
I gotta fall back a little bit to heal.
Yeah, me too. I got you with the heal.
Oh, gotcha. Cool.
We'll make it through this.
I see Warden.
Just hitting for 400.
Let's just take tower.
Shut back off a bit. It's hitting pretty hard. Apparently I gotta hit him again.
He should back off a bit.
Dead.
Hold on.
Show no mercy.
I see Warden.
Let's go to blue lane.
Even on this damn clubber, man. It's hilarious. So right there is a great example of get a couple kills and you're feeling invincible, and then you go off on your own and try to solo the team. It's not going to work out well for you. At a certain point in the game, you're going to want to stick together with your teammates. In general, as a new player, I would say just stick with your teammates, even if it's just one other teammate.
Thank you.
get over here by teammates. Before I get killed. Yo, I got a Wraith and homie over here on me. On the left, careful.
You knew what was going to happen the moment you picked a blade with a lash. It's waiting to be played.
Falling back yet. He met my quota. There. Basically, we're just trying to keep pushing up this lane, and I'm just being really aggressive, trying to make them respect my character. I'm casting my ultimate right when they're using a bunch of their abilities on me that basically negates everything they're doing. So that's gonna make them lose one of their abilities because they have to wait on it to recharge. Also, they know that my abilities are reset now that I've ulted. They're gonna fall back and gives my teammate a chance to push up. A lot going on right there, a lot of special effects happening, but that's essentially the gist of it.
Come stand between me and my revenge.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Let me go buy something real quick, god damn. We're gaming. Refresher time? I think. Oh, it's about to get real refreshed up in here. Watch out, Kelvin, you're solo.
Let's go mid.
I see Viscus.
There's a walking goo pile here.
They're all right there. Careful.
I got a black hole for next team fight.
Oh. Oh, let's yeah, go, baby.
Give me the loot.
Let's go mid.
All right, mid-boss. Let's try to attempt to explain this thing. Mid-boss appears at a certain time in the raid. The team that kills it gets souls, but the most important thing is after you kill it. After you kill a mid-boss, this little diamond thing will come floating out of the ceiling, and once it reaches the bottom, you have to punch it to break it. Whichever team breaks it now gets a faster respawn time, and their minions are faster spawning, and there's more of them. So it's a pretty big advantage. If you're already winning like we are, we can use it to overwhelm the enemy team. Also, if you're behind, it's a great advantage because it can help you kind of catch up to the enemy team.
Just a taste of it.
Oh, God.
There.
Now we've pushed into their base, we've taken out their little sentry towers, and the next thing that we need to do is take out these enemy shrines. There's two shrines on either side of their base, and once you destroy their shrines, their boss will be vulnerable, meaning that you can actually do damage. We're gonna clear out the shrines and then start focusing on the boss. Once we get the towers taken down, the little flying boss guy, you have to shoot him until he goes into his weakened state. And then the weakened state is just like a little orb, and he floats down into the middle of their base right there. You have to actually be down in the middle with him to do damage to him. Once you've got all the way down to zero,
hell yes,
you win the game.
Perfect.
That was a game right there, baby. I know it's a little hectic, but I've really been enjoying the game. Learning MOBAs has been pretty fun for me, coming from an FPS background. So I encourage you, if you like shooters and competitive type games, to give this game a try, because it really has a lot of nuance to it. There's a huge skill ceiling with it. Let me know if you guys found this video helpful, and also let me know down in the comments if there's any other character that you would like to see me play.